Hello, hello, my lovely. Welcome back to my channel. Today, I'm going to unpack this. And you might be thinking, girl, what's in there? Well, I've got 30 shades of Cléonaut Cosmetics. It's the first time I ever bought anything from Cléonaut. I took a big advantage of their Christmas sale, their holiday sale, when they released their new website. And I've got 30 shades plus the empty palette in here. And we are going to unbox this together. I have my little Stanley knife ready. And I'm going to swatch all the shades. We're just gonna get into this, you know. I'm just curious. I really wanted to do this on film because it's fun, you know. Okay, there we are. We got this like what is it? Paper? Yes. We're going to be here for a bit. I'm going to unpack all of these and then I'm going to take them out because seriously. Who wants to wait for this? Okay, it's quite literally the next day because this little tyke had some diarrhea problem. So I had to tend to that. And it was a lot of work getting all the shades out of their packaging. But I've succeeded. So I'm going to swatch them all for you. I'm going to show you all of the swatches. And I'm going to show you all of the shades. I'm going to put Denver down. All right, so I have unpacked all of the shades. And I have them here. Sorry about the mirror. I've put them all in here because it was a thing. It was a lot of work getting all the bubble wrap off because it was self-sticking bubble wrap. It was a lot of work. And then they came in all these like little these thingamajingies. So it was a lot of work getting them all out. I put them in the magnetic palette and I'm going to swatch them all for you. I have the names written down here on my notepad so I don't have to take them out and, you know, see what is what because I am not really dexterous, so it's going to go wrong. All right, the first one is going to be Opulent. That is this one. I'm just going to swatch them on my hands and I'm going to take them off. Wow, as soon as I'm done. This is Opulent. It's like a beautiful pink to lime to some lavender purple in there. It is really, really stunning. Don't mind the scratches because that's Denver. This is Opulent. It's a beautiful shade. Okay, next up is Chandelier. Wow, this is like a... It's like a lime to pink. Beautiful. And this is like one swipe. They are really impressive. Alright, the next one is Foiling. This is a gold to pinkish, I would say. Yeah, gold to peachy pink. Very beautiful. These are all in a collection. I'm going to list the name of the collection down below because I don't remember what the name is. The next one is Enamel, and this is a very beautiful, like, periwinkle purple. This one. Oh my god, look at that. It is so beautiful. This one has like a fuchsia, very bright pink shift to it. So you have like a purple base and then a very bright pink shift. Very stunning. And then we have Seal. That is a blue. Let me see if I have some room. Wow. I'm going to... On my hairy arms, it doesn't swatch too nice. Wow, this is like a blue to gold. Beautiful. So stunning. Next one is Glazed. This is Glazed and this is like a pinky to purple to gold. Very beautiful. Then we go into Spotlight. This is not very... I have to really like build it up or smooth it out. This is Spotlight. It's a very bright pink and then I think it's a periwinkle shift, like a purpley lavender periwinkle shift. But the base isn't that strong. So I think this is more of a topper shade, but very pretty. Then I'm going into Translucency. It's kind of nice to see all these like pinky tones together. It's the bottom one, it's Translucency. I think this has a transparent base as well. So you have like a lighter pink than Spotlight, but it's definitely a pink and it has the same type of shift. It's just cooler toned somehow. All right, then the next one is Grisaille. Do I say that right? I don't know. This is a very... This is the type of shade I don't think really fits my eye. Like my skin tone, but it's like... Or my undertone, but it's very beautiful. It's like a very deep pink base. And then you have a shift that is like a blue to green lime type of deal. Very pretty. Next up is Ornamental. Oh wow, this is very pretty. This is very foiled. This is a gold to like a pink shift. See what I mean? There's like a pinky shift. And in real life, that gold is very bright. And then the like pinky greenish shift is very subtle. So it is very sophisticated and elegant. I love this one. Then the next one is Stencil, which is a very nice deep. I'm going to build this up a little. A deep purple to blue. It's like a purple to blue. You can so easily see that shift going. That is really cool. You see? Wow. Wow, wow, wow. This is a stunning shade. Stencil this was. And then I'm going into Corrosion. That is also a gold. And then to like a almost maroon. I think a deep gold to like a maroon shift. If you see what I mean. Wow. This is really nice. Really nice. That's a, for me also a very difficult shade to wear. Like Grisaille. That like maroony type undertone. That is not. It really doesn't vibe with my undertone. But that's fine. You know. It's. I can just admire it from afar. Alright. Then I have Carving. Which is really interesting. Because this is like. It's very crumbly. Oh my god, I'm going to be covered in glitter. And this is like... what's this? It's like almost a peachy bronze. And then the shift is greenish. Okay, you see the shift? The shift is really subtle though. It's like the sparkles or the glitter in this shade has that like greenish tinge. Really cool. Really cool. I'm going to do one more and then I'm going to take them off again. This is Glacier's Mark. And this is also a like maroony pink. Ooh, I have to really... This one is really crumbly. So I'm just going to tap it into my skin a little bit. Yeah, this has this like maroony reddish base. And then there's a purple shift in there. Oh, it's nice. You know, this is the first time I got anything from Cléonut, so I just wanted to buy a bundle and a few loose ones so I can just try the brand, because I don't know if you have been on the website, and I know they have redone their website. It's beautiful now, but it's still a lot. So it is not easy to make like your decision on what you want to get. So for me, it was like, okay, this is just get a bundle. That's the easiest way to try the brand. So yeah, not everything is going to be my... cup of tea, but that's okay. This is Abrasion, and this also has that like deep pink, very reddish pink, and then with a purple shift. It's really beautiful. I think this one could be a little bit more suited for my eyes. If I wear colors like that maroony shade what I was talking about, then I look like I've been crying, and that's not a look I want to have every day. If I don't have to. This one is really interesting. This is Blaze. It's like a gold peach, and then it has a gold shift. It's the second one from the... Oh, it's... Maybe I should put my settings down a bit. Okay, I put down the like the lights a little, so you can see the color a little bit better. But you see they have that gold shift, and then it goes into this beautiful peach. Really stunning. Next one is Torch, and that is a very red one as well. Very deep color. It's like a hot pink and then a gold shift. Like a greeny gold shift. See what I mean? Wow. This one is really cool as well. Okay, then I have Engrave. This is like, you can see the pink, and then if you shift it, you can see like the green. There's a greenish. It's a very interesting one. It's like almost as if you have like that pink and then a rusty green. It's... I can't explain it. Can you see it? I hope you can see. what I mean. It's not easy to get multichromes, you know, to show up through the color on camera, but I'm trying. All right, then I have, this was engraved, I think. Yeah, so I have Tracery next. It's also a purple. Oh, some of them are really crumbly. I think there's just a lot of glitter in them or something. This is like a purple, a very bright purple, and it has like a pinky shift to it, but it's mainly purple. It's very purple. It's not, you don't really see that like shift very well. And then I am going to clean my hands because I have three left. Then I'm going into Sunbeam, and this one is really pretty. It's like a very light pink, and then it has a goldeny lime green shift. It's so cool. And it's really foiled. This one is stunning, especially for this time of year. It's like a limey gold. Stunning shade. This one is really beautiful. This one is so stunning for this time of year, like spring. Use it with a little bit of pastel. Yes, baby. This one is Kaleidoscope. And it's also pink, but it's like with a more bluey shift. This is Kaleidoscope. It's the second one, and it's more like, let me turn down the brightness a bit, you can see it a little bit better. It's like a pink, and then it shifts a purple, or it's a purple and it shifts a pink, but no, it's like the very the shimmery side of this shade is really purple, bluish purple. Okay, and then this is the last one in this collection or this bundle, and this is Ripple. This is more of a minty to a pink, and it's really cute as well. It's really cute for this time of year. It's really crumbly though, so I'm going to turn up the brightness, turn down the brightness a little bit. It's the third from the top. It's a lime to a pink. I hope you can see. You see that pink shift? It's not very easy to see, but there's a very light pink shift in here. Really cute as well, really summery. These last three were really cute for spring and summer, you know, combine them with a little bit of pastel. Very, very cute. Then I have a few odds and ends, just a few I thought, you know, looked really pretty and I wanted to have. So the first one is Emboss. And this is it's like a reddish pink, and it has a lime shift. So I hope you can see what I mean. You see that lime in that shift, and then you have like almost a reddish pink as a base. Really, really stunning. And then the next one is Embroidery, and this is a very, very stunning shade. It looks a bit like I'm wearing a Divina multichrome on my eyes today, because I am doing a 7 looks with the 7 multichromes I have from the Aurora Flare collection. This is Embroidery, and this is a very deep mossy green, and it shifts a deep purple, red, bronzy. It's like a very classic. I always feel like multichromes kind of do this, that like shift to from green to that like rusty, deep purpley red. Really nice. Really beautiful. And then I'm going over to, this is Gargoyle. This is also a very beautiful green, and it's nice to swatch them side by side so you can see the difference. This one is more like a peacock type of thing. It's kind of what I'm wearing right now. It's a deep green, and then it shifts blue. It's the third one from the top. This one is one of my favorites. I really love the look of this. And then I have also a very deep one, because I do love me a very deep shade. And this is Spire. Okay, I don't want to say one swipe, but almost. It's like a very deep dark purple, and it shifts to a... Why can't I show you properly? You see the shift? You can see the shift a little bit better, I think, like this. It's the fourth one from, it's like the most right one. See, there's like a maroony, almost goldeny. There are multiple colors in here. So you have like a gold, green, a maroon, and a deep purple. Okay, there's a lot going on. There's a lot going on. Then I have 4 left, and I'm going to start off with the lightest one. This is Chromatic. I'm really curious about this one. Ooh, yes. And this is like a, I don't think that it's a transparent base, but it's like peachy. And then it shifts lime to pink. Wow. This has such dimension in real life. And this is really pretty as well with some pastel, combining with pastel looks. You know, last year we had that whole pastel trend. So you probably have a pastel palette in your collection. Then you can combine this one really easily. The next one is Illumination. And this is like, it looks like a mint in the pan. And it shifts. It doesn't really have a shift necessarily, but it's beautifully foiled. It has a bit of a shift, like, I think you can say that it has a shift in all the dimensions of what mint can do. So something like that. And then I have 2 yellowy gold ones. And this is the first one. This is Throne. And this is also just a yellow. I'm going to turn on the tradition again. This is like a yellow, and it has a bit of a pink shift, but it's not, you see, you can see some dimension in the shade, but it's not like you have a very strong shift, but it makes it interesting. It's a very interesting shade. And the last one is Majesty, and it's more of an orange yellow, and it has also some very orange and then yellowy goldy to lime. It's the bottom one. It's like, it looks very orange, and then you see that orange shift and very gold. It's gold with an orange shift, and there's also a little bit of green in here. The ones I picked out, like not in the collection, are very, very interesting. And I think a lot of the ones in the collection I love, and a few are not really for me. But I am so glad I finally got the Tricleonaut. I am so happy I got this. I got this like a stained glass, I think it's from Stained Glass Collection. Empty palette, and all of them are here. They're a little bit jumbled, so I'm going to put them a bit together now. Like, the OCD is not going to run haywire, you know. But yeah, I'm really glad I got these. They are so stunning. And I will do looks with them, but I am not going to do looks with all of them, because that's a little bit much. But I am at the moment doing a series, as I was saying, with the Divina Aurora Flares collection. I have a few of them. I have 7. I have them here. I have 7 of these, and I am doing like looks with them so I can give you some inspiration on how to use multichromes. This one, I wanted to keep it wearable, but this is really out there. So if you're somewhere near, if you are somewhere you can go out or something like that, then this would be a very cool look. But it's not necessarily extremely wearable. All right, ladies, thank you so much for watching. I hope you liked what you saw. If you did, then please give this video a thumbs up. Subscribe if you haven't already, because I would love to see you in my next one. Bye.